Hello students, welcome to the class. So we are going to start with the first topic of 8th standard, that is crop production and management. So basically what all things we are going to discuss in this topic is the basic terminologies like what do we mean by crops, what are the types of crops, what are the what do you mean by agriculture? In agriculture, so we have so many things like sericulture, we have horticulture, we have all these basic terms we'll be discussing. Apart from that, we'll be discussing about agricultural practices, agricultural implements we are going to see. We are going to talk about manures and fertilizers which are being used. Then at the last part, we are going to discuss about irrigation. What are the different methods of irrigation? Crop protection, how it is being protected after immediately it is being harvested and during storage and all. And lastly, we are going to discuss about animal husbandry. Okay. So to begin with, see, as we all know that all living organisms, yeah, whether it is a green plants or animals, they need food for the survival. And we know that the green plants, they do prepare their own food, right? So green plants, you have studied in your previous year, you have studied about nutrition in plants and animals, right? So whether it is green plants or other organisms. What do I mean by other organisms? I mean that I'm speaking about human beings. I'm speaking about animals also. Okay. I'm speaking about human beings as well as I'm speaking about animals. Yeah. So whatever it is, when I speak about green plants, they need food. Basically, they do need food for the survival. Now, if you look at green plants and if you look at animals, it is different, right? So when I look at green plants, the green plants, they prepare their own food by the process of photosynthesis. Yes. And what is photosynthesis? You all know only. Photosynthesis is what? The process in which green plants, they have got some green pigment, right? And that green pigment is called chlorophyll. This chlorophyll, what it does in presence of a sunlight, it will take the carbon dioxide from the atmosphere and from the roots, it will take water. And in the presence of sunlight, it will prepare the food. It will prepare food. That is nothing but carbohydrates. It will prepare carbohydrates, right? So green plants prepare food by the process of photosynthesis. Is that right? So this is food preparation done by green plants. So the food which is required for the nutrition of the green plants, it is prepared by itself. That's the reason what are green plants called? They are called as autotrophs. Autotrophs. So in nutrition, we have two types, right? We have autotrophism and heterotrophism. So what do we mean by autotrophism? The process by which the organism prepares its own food, that is called autotrophism. And the organisms which prepare their own food are called autotrophs. And which are those autotrophs? They are nothing but what? They are nothing but producers. Yes, they are nothing but producers. So they prepare their own food by the process of what? By the process of photosynthesis. And rest all the other animals, if you see. If we speak about all the other animals, including human beings, they prepare, they depend on food. They depend on green plants for the food. Yes. So I can say they directly or indirectly depend on green plants for food. Right. They directly or indirectly depend on green plants for food. What do you mean by directly? That means there are, and these, what are these called? What are these called? These organisms which depend for food, what are they called? They are called heterotrophs. Correct. They are called what? Heterotrophs. They are called heterotrophs. They depend on green plants for their food. Yes. When I speak about direct or indirect dependence, when they depend directly on the green plants for the food, yes, they are now called as herbivores. Under heterotrophs, we have herbivores. Herbivores are what? They are dependent only on green plants for food. They are dependent only on green plants for food. Then we have carnivores. Yes. What they are? Carnivores are those animals which are dependent on food on herbivores. Yes. So this is indirect. herbivorous animals. They're dependent on herbivorous animals. And then we have omnivores. The best example for omnivores is what? Human beings. They are both dependent on green plants as well as herbivores. Yes, as well as animals for food. They're called omnivores, right? They're called omnivores. So herbivores, direct dependence on green plants. Carnivores and omnivores, direct as well as indirect dependence. Yes, carnivores, it is indirect dependence. It depends on herbivores. Like for example, your goat and deer, they all eat green plants. So they are herbivores. Carnivores like tiger, lion, they eat goat, they eat deer, right? They are carnivores. Omnivores, human beings are the best examples. Human beings are omnivores. Some are dependent only on plants, some are dependent only on animals, and some are dependent both on plants as well as on animals, right? So we have, apart from this, we have still more types of heterotrophs. Yeah, well, some of them include saprophytes. Yes, saprophytes are those organisms which depend on the dead and remains. Dead organisms for food. Yes, they depend on the dead remains of plants and animals. They are nothing but saprophytes. And still one more, we have parasites. Parasites. These depend on the living organisms. Yes, these are very small microorganisms which are present inside the body, like worms and all. They are parasites. And we have something called insectivorous plants. Insectivorous plants. These plants, they do not have chlorophyll. Okay. So due to absence of chlorophyll, what happens? They cannot prepare their own food in the presence of sunlight. Therefore, they depend on the insects for food. They depend on insects for food. Venus flytrap is the example for insectivorous animal plants. Yes. So these all are what? They are nothing but heterotrophs. Yes. Heterotrophs. So we have basically autotrophs, which are called producers, and we have heterotrophs, which are called consumers. Yes. So this we have studied in our lower classes about nutrition in plants as well as in animals, right? So when we look at all these animals, all these things, if we observe all these organisms, the green plants, they prepare their own food by the process of photosynthesis, while the animals obtain their food directly or indirectly from the plants. So now the question comes, what about human beings? What about human beings? The question is, what about human beings? Just now we discussed human beings are omnivores. They depend both on plants as well as on animals for food. But where, if you speak about plants, directly can I eat a plant, right? Yes. So where do humans get their food from, and how do they meet their daily requirement? Yes. So humans grow plants and they rare animals. When we speak about human beings, they grow what? They grow plants and they rare animals. So by this, they can meet their nutrition demands. Yes. To meet their daily requirements. But since the human population, when you look at human population, is it not increasing day by day? The human population is increasing day by day. Yes. So their food requirement is also increasing. So this, since human population is increasing, correct? The requirement for food. The requirement for food is also increasing day by day. Correct? It is also increasing day by day. Is that right? Yes, therefore, it is necessary what? It is necessary. What is necessary? It is necessary to improve or to increase the necessary to improve. Or instead of saying or, let me say to improve and increase. Increase what? The quantity of food production. Correct? Yes, quantity of food production to meet what? To meet the demands, to meet the increasing demands, correct? So in order to meet the increasing demands, it becomes necessary to increase the food quantity. Now this food requirement, how it is achieved? It is achieved by farming. So one way is achieved by farming more land. Yes, cultivation you call it as. By farming more land, we can achieve this requirement. Yes, then increasing the food production. Correct? Increasing the food production. By increasing the food production is the another way. And then by managing the produced food. Yes or no? Yes, very important. You have to manage it also. Managing the production and distribution of food. Distribution of food. Understanding. So to meet the demands of the increasing population, it is required to farm more land, increase the food production, and then whatever food is produced has to be managed and distributed properly. Thus, it is agriculture that makes possible to thus it is what? Agriculture. Yes, it is agriculture that makes possible to sustain a huge population at one time. Huge population at one time. Yes. So basically, what do we understand by the term agriculture then? Yes, when we come across agriculture, we have so many things linked to it. Like we have something called crops. Yes or no? So since all the living organisms, they need food to survive. If for a large scale demand of food, can I say like this? For large scale demand of food for humans. Yes, what has been started? The people have started agriculture. They have come with agriculture and agricultural practices. Agricultural practices. Yes. Yes. So how, when we speak about agriculture, what is agriculture? Yes. What do you mean by this term agriculture? You have come across this so many times. Yes. Agriculture. What is this agriculture actually? It is the human activity of cultivating the crops. Human activity of cultivating the crops, of cultivating the crops and plantations. Plantations for what? For large scale production. Large scale production of food and even goods such as biofuels, fibers and animal feed. Animal feed. We'll come to it. We'll discuss one by one everything in detail. Yes. So what do we mean by agriculture? It is the human activity of cultivating the crops and plantations for large scale production of food. And apart from that, what is being done? Even goods are produced, such as biofuel comes out of it. Manure, what we use. Fibers we get. Even animal feed, yes, whatever remains, husk, what remains after getting the crops is what? It is fed for animals. Yes. Then what are crops then? Crops. What are these? So crops, when the plants of same type are cultivated, yes, when plants of same type, are cultivated, at a place, on very large scale, are known as crops. They are known as crops. Yes, same thing. When you cultivate it at a very large scale, what we call it as? We call it as crops. So agriculture, human activity of cultivating the crops and plantations for the large scale production of the food and goods, such as all these things. Or you can also say it as the applied branch of biology. Yes, it is the branch of science which deals with cultivation of, it deals with what? It deals with, means what all comes in it. Yes, so it deals with cultivation of crops. First thing, then rearing of the animals, of the animals. So agriculture includes all these things: cultivation of the plants or crops, rearing of the animals. Generally, the art of practicing or the art of practice of cultivating land is referred to as agriculture. So what is agriculture? It is the art of practice of cultivating the land. Yes. So the branch of agriculture which deals with, there is one more branch of agriculture, right? The branch of agriculture which deals with, food, then health and management of animals is called, as animal husbandry. What it is termed as? Animal husbandry. Yes. So this is about animal husbandry, which comes under agriculture only. Yes. And then just now we discussed what are crops. Crops, when the plants of same kind are grown or cultivated at one place on a large scale, we call them crops. We call them as crops. Is that right? Okay. So here, all living organisms require food. The energy from the food is utilized by the organism for carrying out various processes such as digestion, respiration, excretion. Yes, we have discussed that food is required for the animals. Now, why the food is required for the animals? To carry, to get energy. And how, why do they get, why do they need energy? In order to carry out the various processes of their life. Yes or no? Internal processes, if you talk about, we need energy to breathe. To breathe in oxygen, to give out carbon dioxide. We need energy for digesting our food. Whatever food we eat should be digested in our stomach. Then only we will feel hungry in the next 6 hours, right? Then excretion, whatever food we have taken in, the wastes have to be thrown out of the body. Yes, for all these processes, for doing work also, we need energy. Externally, we need energy. And that is obtained how? That is obtained from the food. Plants can make their own food themselves, but animals, including humans, cannot. So plants which make their own food, they are called what? They are called as autotrophs, producers. And animals which depend on plants for food, what they are called? They are called as heterotrophs, or they are also called as consumers. We get our food from plants or animals or both. Yes, if you are a vegetarian, we take food only from the plants. If we are a non-vegetarian, we depend both on plants as well as animals. Yes, so it depends. So in our category, in our country, three categories of crops are being grown. Yes, so just now we discussed what are crops. What are crops? When the same crop is being grown over a large, over a land on a large scale, we call it as a crop. We call it as a crop. When we speak about these crops, we have so many examples. Like we have wheat crop, we have jawar, we have barley, we have so many crops are being present. So plants of the same kind that are grown and cultivated as a source of food. Yes, they are called crops. Yes, types of crops. Crops, here I have shown you three types. But basically, how we can classify these crops is, see, these crops, which are generally grown in winter season, yes, that is from October to March. Yes, these are called as rabi crops. What they are called as? Rabi crops. Yes. So rabi crops are crops which are grown for generally in winter season, that is from October to March. And there are crops which are grown in rainy season, that is from July to October. July to October. And these such crops which are grown in rainy season, they are called kharif crops. They are called what? Kharif crops. Yes. So we have basically two types of crops. One is your rabi crops and another one is your kharif crops, right? Rabi and kharif crops. Okay. Now here, what I want to say here is, yes, let us look at the slide here. The crops which are grown in rainy season, that is from June to September or October, they are called kharif crops. Examples. Yes, examples include paddy, that is our rice, maize, soya bean, groundnut, cotton. These are all what? Kharif crops. They are grown in rainy season. Then rabi crops, the crops which are grown in winter season, that is from October to March, they are called rabi crops. Examples are wheat, gram, peas, mustard, and linseeds. These are rabi crops. And the third is zaid crops, which are grown in summer season. They are called summer crops. Yes, the crops grown in summer season are called zaid crops, like moong, muskmelon, watermelon, cucumber, gourds, all types of gourds, bitter gourds are the examples for zaid crops. Okay, so kharif crops, the crops which are grown during monsoon. Yes, the crops which are grown during monsoon. Kharif crops, which are grown, rainy season means what? Which are grown during monsoon. Yes, rainy season, that is from July to October, we call them kharif crops. Examples include what? It is maize, then we have millet, that is your bajra, then we have cotton. Yes, cotton crops. These are all kharif crops. Yes, so seeds of these crops, how they are being grown, kharif crops especially, the seeds of these crops, yes, the seeds of these crops, the seeds of these crops, they are sowing, right, in the beginning of the monsoon, in the beginning of monsoon. Yes, after maturation. Yes, after they germinate, right? So after maturation, what happens? After maturation, these crops are harvested at the end of the monsoon season. Once they germinate, they become plants. They give out proper, proper crops. They are being harvested at the end of monsoon, that is around October, November and all. Yes, rabi crops, these are what? These are grown in winter season. For example, your wheat, gram, mustards, seeds of these crops, they are sown in the beginning of the winter. Yes, they are sown in the beginning of winter. And after maturation, they are harvested at the end of the winter, say around April, May, they are being harvested. Yes, they are being harvested at the end of the winter. Yes, then what are zaid crops? They are grown in summer. They are grown in summer season. Yes, and the examples of zaid crops include what? The examples include all of our watermelon, cucumber and all. Yes, cultivation of the crops involves following activities. Now see, before going to the cultivation, what are these agricultural practices? Yes, cultivation means what? What all we have to do for growing proper plants to get better yield of the crops. Yes, so that is studied under something called agricultural practices. Okay, so what are these agricultural practices? All the activities which the farmers do for cultivation of plants. Yes, so what are agricultural practices? All the activities like getting good quality seeds, then sowing them at the proper time, right? Then proper irrigation facilities, proper fertilizers being given, then waiting for them to grow into good plants. Yes, all these activities which the farmers do for the cultivation of plants of plants is called what? Is called agricultural practices. So to do all these things, to do all these practices, for doing all these various activities, for doing all these various activities, yes, for doing all these various activities, farmer needs what? Farmer cannot do it all the time with his hand or by using the bullocks, right? Farmer needs implement different types of tools. He needs different types of tools. Yes, different types of tools are required. And these tools, yes, what are these? The tools which are involved in cultivation, which are involved in cultivation of plants. The tools which are involved in the cultivation of plants are called what? Are called agricultural implements. What they are called? Agricultural implements. Getting? They are called agricultural implements. Okay, so farmers perform, see, these agricultural practices are not performed anyhow. The farmers, they perform agricultural practices in a particular sequence. In a particular sequence, yes. Immediately to the soil, we do not give fertilizers, right? First, we make prepare the soil, then we will sow the seeds, yes. So, in a particular sequence, the farmer carries out his agricultural practices. He carries out his agricultural practices. So the various agricultural practices which are involved, the various agricultural practices, yes, we'll just brief out, then we'll discuss one by one. Agricultural practices which are being done by the farmer are, first, what he does, he prepares the soil. Preparation of soil. So if the soil is not prepared properly, preparation means what? He will not mix anything and prepare the soil. Preparation means proper tilling of the soil has to be done. Yes. Once the soil is prepared, then what he does is he goes for sowing of the seeds. He goes for sowing of the seeds. He will put the seeds into the soil. After that, he uses addition of manures and fertilizers. Yes, for proper growth of the plants, he uses manure and fertilizers to keep the plants away from the insects. Yes, he uses manure and fertilizers. Then proper irrigation methods. Irrigation means what? Water giving tendency to during agriculture. Usage of water during agriculture. That is called irrigation. You cannot give any much amount of water to any type of plants. I cannot get paddy plants in hot summer. Or if I put little water, paddy plants are grown in a standby water, right? And similarly, I cannot grow any other plants just by sprinkling water, right? So irrigation practices are there. Then protection from weeds, the waste, the unwanted plants are being grown. Yes, you have to protect it from those plants which are called weeds. Then we have harvesting. Once we get the crops, we have to harvest them. Harvesting technique. Then comes the storage. Very important concept. So this is all what? These are all the various agricultural practices. To do all these various agricultural practices, the farmer utilizes different tools. And what are those tools called? Agricultural implements. What they are called? Agricultural implements. Yes, the various agricultural implements, what he makes use of are, he makes use of plow. We'll discuss them one by one. Then he makes use of hoe. Then he makes use of a cultivator. He uses seed drill. Yes, these are all ancient techniques. Nowadays, we have come with so much modernization in the agricultural practices, like, right? Even irrigation also, there are different techniques being used. So here, these are some basic terms which are being associated with what? Which are being associated with the agricultural land. Yes. So, preparation, first one is what? Soil preparation. So, what is done in soil preparation? It involves loosening and tilting of the soil, ploughing and watering. Yes. So, what does the first step involves? Yes. So, what is the first step? Soil preparation. What all is being done in soil preparation? First and foremost, what is being done? Yes, preparing of soil is the first step in cultivating crops for the food production. Thus, soil is prepared for sowing the seeds of the crops. This is carried out by using various processes and tools. Yes, so for preparing the soil, what all we do is we loosen the soil. The soil will be very hard. We have to first loosen it out. That is called preparation of the soil. Yes, and that is being done by different techniques. Yes, we can do it by different techniques, like we use tilling and plowing. Tilling and plowing. So what is done here is the process of loosening of soil and turning of the soil upside down. Turning of the soil is called plowing, and it is done by using what? It is done by using plow. Yes. So what is a plow? You can see here. I can show you all here. We have a plow here. Yes, plow. So this is used for tilling the soil, adding fertilizers to the crops, removing weeds, scraping of the soil. So many things are there for this plow. Yes, this implement is made up of wood and drawn by a pair of pulls. Yes, you can see this picture. Farmer is standing here, and this is what the center part, what you're seeing, it is plow. It is being pulled by the bulls. So when it goes on pulling, this hard part, what you're seeing, it is called plowshare. Yes, it is into the soil. So it will go on pick the soil. It will go on tilt the soil. Yes, it will make the soil loosen, and it will make upside down. This is made up of wood. It is called plow shaft. Yes. So you can see here, this is called plow. This usually the farmers in the village, they usually offer blessings to this. Yes. They bless it. They actually adore it like a god's, idol. So they give so much importance to it because this is the first step. If this is done proper, if the loosening of the soil is done proper, if the tilling of the soil is being done proper, if you do properly the soil upside down, then sowing the seeds and all goes on very well. So being the first step, we use this plow. What is being used? The plow is being used. Yes. Then the second step is what? The second step is sowing. Yes. So plow is what? Plow is device. Yes. I can explain you here. So plow is what? Plow is the device. So you can define it as a device that is used by farmers for different purposes. Device used by farmers. A device you can call it as an implement also, or a tool. You call it as a device or you call it as a tool used by farmers for different purposes. Yes, what are those different purposes used? Different purposes such as adding fertilizers, tilling, and loosening of the soil. Yes. So for this purpose, plow is being used. Yes. Further, it is also used for adding fertilizers to the soil. Then it is used for removing the weeds. Removing the weeds and scraping the soil. Soil usually becomes hard once all the crops are being used. To scrap the soil, it is being used. Yes. The plowshare, if you see, it is triangular. It is made up of wooden. It is made up of iron. Yes, like this, it is what you see. This is plowshare. It is triangular. Yes, it is triangular iron strip. Yes, a plowshaft is the main part of the plow. It is straight, like this. So this is called plowshaft. What it is called? Plowshaft. And this is what? Plowshare. Yes, it is plowshare, which is made up of iron strips. And this is plowshaft, which is wooden. Yes, it is the main part, which is made by using a wooden log, or you can use a wood. The other end of the shaft has got handles. So the other hand is attached to a beam which is placed on the bullock's neck. We place it on the bull's neck, correct? A wooden traditional plow can be operated by a pair of ox and a man. Nowadays, if you see, the wooden plows are being replaced by iron plows. They are being replaced by iron plows. Yes, instead of using animals for the work, we can use it directly as usual. The second method is what? The second method is sowing. Sowing. Even for land loosening, you know, apart from plow, you can also go for hoe. Yes, this hoe is nothing but it is a tool that is used to dig up the soil. You might have seen it is something like this. Yes, it is having like this, and it is having a stick here. Yes, what we do is we use it to dig the soil. To dig the soil, yes, to dig the soil. It is long. Yes, it is long here. So to dig the soil, we use this. Yes, also hoe can be used to also loosen the soil. Loosen the soil and to dig the soil before plantation. Yes, before planting a sapling. Then even we can go for cultivator. Yes, for first step, that is soil preparation, we can either use plow, we can use hoe, you can use cultivator. Cultivator. So cultivator is nothing but it is attached to the tractor and helps in loosening of the soil. See, if you use plow, it is very tedious work until and unless the bullock drags it. Only one layer, one what you say, one lane of the farm gets loosened, right? Again, the farmer has to continue it, right? So if you use hoe, it is only being done by the farmer. He has to go on digging it up. But nowadays, by the modernization in the agriculture also, cultivators have come. What they do, they help, they are attached to the tractors, yes? And at a stretch, around 5 to 6 lanes are being loosened. Yes, of the land are being used. So cultivators are used instead of plows since they are what? Since they are faster. Since they are faster. So for soil preparation, either you go for plow or you go for hoe or you can go for cultivator. And which is the better one? Cultivator is the better one because it will use less manwork and less animal work, and it is much faster. Yes, it is much faster. Second step is sowing. So sowing is what? Sowing is the process of planting the seeds in the soil. Or you can say instead of planting, you say putting. Putting the seeds in the soil. In the soil. We call it as sowing. Yes, the seeds are being sown in the soil that is loosened by the cultivator. You can use cultivator, you can use plow, it can use hoe, you can loosen the soil. Once the soil is loosened, suppose the soil is loosened in this area, then we go on putting the seeds. That process of putting the seeds is called what? It is called sowing. It is called sowing. Yes. Now the question arises, what type of seeds? See, only when the seeds are of better quality, you will get the plants also of better quality. So here it is very important to check the quality of seeds. Very, very important to check the quality of seeds, right? You cannot use any type of seeds. So quality of the seeds is an important factor which determines what? Yes, it is an important factor. Important factor which determines what? The crop yield. Which determines the crop yield, how better yield you will get. It depends on what? The quality of the seeds. So selection of good seeds is done by putting the seeds in water. So how do you do selection? It is ancient method. So selection of good seeds is done by putting them in water. In water. Yes, so this is the selection, how to select the quality of seeds. Now, what are the traditional tools for this? Before the advent of modern agricultural machinery, yes, before the advent of modern agricultural machinery, now we have modern all agricultural machineries, right? Agricultural machinery we have. But earlier, The farmers only used to do all the things, right? So before the advent of modern agricultural machinery, yes, traditional tools were being used by the farmers. The traditional tools involve for sowing again, they involve plows, they involve shovels, they involve pickaxes, all these things. The traditional use tool used to sow the seed. The traditional tool used to sow the seed used was, it was like a funnel. It was like a funnel. Once seeds were put in this funnel, they would go to 2 to 3 tubes having sharp ends. Yes, they would go to two, three to two tubes having sharp ends. The end will pierce into the soil and place the seeds there. So it was something like this. When the seeds you put here, from here, it used to go from. This had around, say, it was something like this. It had 2 to 3 sharp edges. And the seeds would enter here. So it had like this, sharp edges. Yes, it had sharp edges like this. The seeds would enter here. And these would, they would go into the soil. Yes, they would pierce into the soil. And the seeds used to get sowed there. They used to get sown there. So this was being used in the old, ancient tools, traditional tool, you can say. Today, what we use is we use seed drill. We use seed drills. So, what are these seed drills? Seed drills, they are used for sowing with the help of tractors. Again, like how you use cultivators for plowing the land, like that, we use seed drills for sowing with the help of tractors. So, it ensures that the seeds are sown. See, here what may happen is here we at one corner there might be two or more seeds fallen, and at other place there might be no seeds, right? So, seed drills informs, ensures what? It ensures that seeds are sown uniformly. It ensures what? Seeds are, so I'll write it here. So, we have seed drill for it, modern techniques. Seed drill. So it is useful for what? Because it ensures the seeds are sown uniformly. That means properly, uniformly they are being sown so that at a particular depth, at a particular depth, and are covered by soil after sowing. After sowing. Correct? They are covered by soil after sowing. So this is why we use seed drills. Yes. And some in some cases we are going for nursery also. New techniques there. So nursery is what? It is a place where young plants and trees are grown. So it is a place where young plants, or you can say instead of plants, you can say saplings. Young saplings are grown, and you can take from there and grow it in the, cultivate it in the fields. Yes, are grown for planting elsewhere. So nursery acts as repository of saplings. So what I can say nursery as repository of saplings. Of saplings. Yes, nursery is there. Then coming to the next step, that is what? Let us see here. So sowing. Sowing is the process of putting the seeds into the soil. Once the seeds are being put into the soil, they undergo germination. Yes, they germinate. So what happens there later? There is germination of seeds. Germination of seeds. So germination of seeds happens. So this happens when you sow the seeds properly in the soil. Yes, it happens when the seeds is sown. Sown in the land and watered. Yes, that is also required, right? And it is watered. So from germinated seeds, from the germinated seeds, it sprouts out. Germinated seeds means what? They sprout out. From the germinated seeds, a plant emerges. A plant emerges. Yes, and starts to grow. Understanding? So germination means what? It is nothing but sprouting. Sprouting of the seeds. So it happens only when the seed is sown properly at a particular depth in the land and it is watered regularly. Yes, from the germinated seeds, a plant emerges and starts to grow. Now, once it starts to grow, adding of manure and fertilizers becomes very important. So adding manure and fertilizers, the substances which are added to the soil in the form of nutrients to improve the production of the crops and fertility of the soil are called manure and fertilizers. So as soon as I sow, much ever better quality seeds I choose, I get it to my land, I sow them, I do soil preparation perfectly, I sow them properly into the uniformly, what happens, adding the, if the seed has to grow very well, if the plant has to be developed very well, then what is the third step? Adding of manure and fertilizers to increase the fertility of soil, to increase the nutritional value of the crops, we use manure. To get better yield, we use manure and fertilizers. So manures and fertilizers are what? They are the substances added to the soil to increase their fertility. So substances added to soil to increase their fertility. To increase their fertility is called what? To increase their fertility are called manures and fertilizers. So what is the difference between manures and fertilizers? See, manure, it is what? It is made up of, made by decomposition of organic matter. Decomposition of organic substances. Organic substances, or it might be the excreted wastes of animals. Yes, this is manure. And what are fertilizers? They are nothing but fertilizers. They are made of inorganic chemicals. So fertilizers are man-made. What are fertilizers? They are man-made. They are made up of inorganic chemicals. So differences, if you see, fertilizer is an inorganic chemical. Whereas manure, it is prepared from the organic matter, such as it can be human waste, animals waste. It can be waste of humans. It can be waste of animals, cow dung, farm waste, everything. Fertilizers are manufactured in factories. Yes, I can take a difference here. We can quote about the difference between what? Fertilizers and manures. So I can write here manure and here what I'll write? Fertilizers. So what do you mean by manure? Yes, manure, it is prepared from organic matter. Organic matter, such as what? Such as humans and animal excreta. Excreta, that is waste. Then cow dung. Then farm waste. Vegetable waste. Yes, vegetable waste. From all these things, we prepare manure. Then what is fertilizer? Fertilizers are inorganic chemicals made up of inorganic chemicals. They are made up of inorganic chemicals. Second thing, manures are prepared in farms. They are prepared in farms. We need not go anywhere. Prepared in farms itself. Whereas fertilizers are prepared where? They are manufactured in factories. In factories. Yes. Then manure. manures need to be added in large quantity as the nutrient content is less. Manures nutrient content is less. Is less. Whereas here nutrient content is high. Is high. So since the nutrient content is less, manures have to be used. Manures need to be added in large quantities. Whereas, since nutrient quantity is high in fertilizers, they are needed to be added comparatively in less smaller quantities. In smaller quantities, right? Coming to manures. Manures provide a lot of humus to soil. Provide a lot of humus, that is organic matter, to soil. Whereas fertilizers do not provide any humus. Do not provide any humus. Humus. Manures, what are the advantages and disadvantages? These are the differences between manures and fertilizers. What are the advantages of using manures? The advantage of using manures is they do not make soil to lose its fertility. Or you can say they increase the fertility of soil. They increase the fertility of soil by providing humus and all, fertility of soil. And they are completely biodegradable. Completely biodegradable or degradable. Degradable means what? They are completely decomposed. Correct? Whereas fertilizers, if you use fertilizers, what they do? They decrease the fertility of soil. They decrease the fertility of soil. And they decrease the fertility of soil and they are non-degradable. They do not decompose. Since they are made up of inorganic salts, they are non-degradable. They do not decompose. And therefore cause what? Cause soil pollution. And even when water flows through it in a rainy season, it joins water bodies and also causes what? Water pollution. Also causes water pollution. Yes. So disadvantages of using fertilizers. Excessive use of fertilizers causes what? Soil pollution, water pollution. And even when you spray the fertilizers, it also causes air pollution. So it causes pollution, excessive use. It can also change the pH of the soil. Change the pH of a soil in certain rates. Yes. So it decreases the fertility of soil. It is non-biodegradable and cause pollution. Yes. So this is the differences between manure and fertilizers. Yes. Manure and fertilizers. So adding of manure and fertilizers also depends, should be properly selected. Then leaving the land fallow. Yes. Before irrigation, we have something called leaving the land fallow. When the land is left fallow for a certain period of time, the land, what do you mean by leaving the land fallow? Yes. Fallow means here, I can show you. What is the next step? Leaving the land fallow. So what do you mean by this? When the land is left for fallow, when the land is left fallow for certain period of time, for certain period of time. What happens is the land replenishes, regenerates, replenishes its nutrients by itself, by itself. That's the reason why you have to do why you have to leave the land. Yes, what does it do? It replenishes the nutrients by itself. And this land can be used for agriculture again. It can be used for agriculture again. Yes. Then even after that, you have to be very careful while doing irrigation. Yes, while doing irrigation. So what do we mean by irrigation? Supply of water to the crops at appropriate level, at appropriate intervals is called irrigation. So what do we mean by irrigation? Supplying of water to the crops, supplying of the water to the crops or at proper levels, at proper intervals, it is called what? It is called irrigation. The supply of water to the land or the crops to help them growth is called what? It is called irrigation. So irrigation is nothing but it is the artificial. Usually irrigation happens by raining. Yes or no? So irrigation. How land gets water properly? It is by rain. Natural method is what? Natural method is rain, by rain. Yes, but sometimes what happens, all the areas we cannot expect rain at the normal times. So irrigation is being done. Yes, natural method of watering the entire agricultural practices is by rain. But here, irrigation is what? It is the artificial application of water to the soil. You use different tubes, you use pumps, you use sprays. Yes or no? Sprinkler system you have, drip irrigation you have. Yes, you make use of so many different things. All these are what? These are all called irrigation methods. What they are called? They are called irrigation methods. So irrigation is usually used in the areas where rainfall, where you use irrigation, where you do irrigation, where rainfall is irregular. Rainfall is irregular. Or in dry areas where rainfall does not occur at all, we go for irrigation where drought is expected. So there are many irrigation systems in which water is supplied. Like you have drip irrigation, you have surface irrigation. We have so many techniques, we have so many irrigation methods, right? So rain-fed farming is what? It is the natural application of water to the soil through direct rainfall. That is called rain-fed farming. Yes, it is natural method to the soil, through which natural application of water to the soil, correct? Through the direct rainfall. But relying on the rainfall is a less likely to result in contamination of the food products. Yes, we cannot always expect rain to be occurring at the proper time. So on the other hand, artificial applications of water increase the risk of contamination. So irrigation is what? It is the artificial application of water to the soil through various tubes, pumps, sprays, and all. Irrigation is usually done where rainfall is irregular or where droughts are expected. Yes, where the no rainfall for the whole year, droughts are expected, there we go for irrigation. So there are many types of irrigation systems in which water is supplied to the entire field uniformly. So irrigation water can come from groundwater. So you can use wells. Groundwater means what? Wells. Correct. You can go for wells. Then you can use through sprinkler system, springs. Yes, we can go for springs. Yes, then we can go for surface water like rivers and all. Even other sources such as treated wastewater, desalinated water can also be used. So types of irrigation system, we have surface irrigation. So water is distributed over across land by gravity. No mechanical pump is involved. Localized irrigation means water is distributed under low pressure. Okay, drip irrigation, you might have heard across this, drip irrigation, where the crop drops of water are delivered near the roots of the plant, exactly near. Suppose this is a root through pipeline, here exactly there is a hole and water exactly falls near the roots. So water is delivered near the roots of the plants. So evaporation and runoff of the water is minimized here. Then we have sprinkler system. You might have seen all these things in the farms, right? Sprinkler system, where water is distributed over the head. High pressure sprinklers are used. Then sprinklers are moving in proper directions. They are circulating. They are moving in circular manner. And the water gets uniformly distributed over the entire land. Yes. So these are all different methods for irrigation, which are being used for irrigation, right? Then protect. protection of the weeds. So weeds are the unwanted plants that grow along with the crops. So its removal is a must for the better growth of the crops. These can be controlled by different techniques. So what are those techniques? We'll be discussing in our next class. Hope you have understood till here everything, all the steps, soil preparation, sowing, adding manure, fertilizers, irrigation, then protection from the weeds. What are the steps? We will discuss them in the next class. For now, thank you.